Hello, this is Dr. Rohde. This video will show how to use the TI84 calculator to find probabilities in the normal distribution. Let's look at this example here. The WAIS IQ test is normally distributed with a mean of 100 and a standard deviation of 15. Find the following values to complete the statements. A. The percentage of individuals with an IQ score between 95 and 120 is. B. The proportion of individuals with an IQ score greater than 120 is. And C. The probability a randomly selected individual has an IQ score less than 95 is. Now, first notice that in each of these questions, it's asked a slightly different way, but in actuality, it's asking for the same thing. It's just the format of how you type the answer is different and the semantics and how you think about it. Here, we have the percentage of individuals in the entire population with the IQ score between these two values. So what we do is we use the calculator and we get what's really the proportion, and we just convert that to a percentage by multiplying by 100 or moving the decimal to the right two places. B is stated as proportion. And that is what the calculator will give us. It will find the proportion greater than 120 or between any two ranges. And then C asks for the probability. Well, the probability is a proportion, and it's in the calculator, it's listed as a decimal when it comes out in the output. And we generally round to four decimal places, and we will in this example. But whatever homework problem or test problem you're working on, make sure you follow the rounding rules for the given question. So what we're going to do is use the TI84 calculator to find these values. Above the VARS key on the TI84 calculator, you'll see DISTR. And notice in this case, it's in blue letters. In order to make the calculator do the blue command, I have to hit the blue second button. And then I hit DISTR. And what I get is a menu here of probability distributions. And we're going to use the normal CDF function, the normal cumulative distribution function. We're not going to use normal PDF. The normal cumulative distribution function, normal CDF, finds the area under the normal bell curve between any given two numbers. And that is what's going to give us our percentage, proportion, or probability. The normal PDF command finds the height of the normal bell curve at a specific point. We want number two, normal CDF. You can either arrow down and hit enter on number two or type the number two. Now the TI-84 in its recent edition has a function called StatWizard. And in the StatWizard, we get these menu options which help guide us to how to enter the values in order to reach our solution. If I look at part A, I want the percentage of individuals with an IQ score between 95 and 120. So I have a range of values here, and the lower limit of that range is 95, and the upper limit of that range is 120. So I'm going to type in those lower and upper limits in the appropriate place. My lower limit was 95, so next to lower, I'm going to type 95. Then I cursor down, using the down arrow, to upper. The upper limit of this particular range of values is 120. So type 120. The next thing it asks for is the mean, mu. The mean was given as 100. Next, we need to enter the standard deviation, sigma. The standard deviation is 15. Then I arrow down to paste and hit enter. And what this will do is take the normal CDF command and paste it into the calculator's command screen. So I must hit enter one more time. And now I get my result, 0.5393, so on. Well, rounded to four decimals, this is 0.5393. But this particular problem asks for it as a percentage. So you can either multiply by 100 or just with your mind's eye, move the decimal to the right two places. So if I had it rounded to four digits to begin with, my percentage would be 53.93%. So, the percentage of individuals with an IQ score between 95 and 120 is 53.93%. Okay, well, let's go back and now do Part B. In Part B, we want the proportion of individuals with an IQ score greater than 120. In this case, since it's a proportion, we won't bother to change it to a percent. We'll just leave it in its decimal form. So, I want to do second vars to open up the distribution menu, and I want to choose choice 2, normal CDF. Now let's think about what this problem says. I want greater than 120. So that means 120 or more. So the lowest the value can be is 120. The highest it could be is infinity. The reason why that is because the normal probability distribution itself, the function, is a theoretical distribution that models real-world situations. And the mathematical model has tails that stretch all the way out to the right to positive infinity and all the way to the left to negative infinity. So if I'm greater than 120, even though no one has an infinity IQ, theoretically, for the function, you must consider that. So my lower bound here is 120, and my upper bound is infinity. The problem is the calculator doesn't have an infinity button. It only understands actual numbers. Well, if you think about what infinity is, it's a really big number. So what we're going to do is type a really big number into the upper limit. So my lower limit now is 120. So I type that for my lower limit. Then I arrow down. And for my upper limit, well, a really big number could be 10 raised to the 99 power. So 10, and then the exponent button is this caret right here. It's flashing red. And then I say 99. So now that will simulate infinity for all practical purposes in the calculator. The mean is still 100, right? And the standard deviation is 15. Then I go down and paste. This will put it in the command screen. If I hit enter, it will give me my result. So the proportion of individuals with an IQ score greater than 120 is 0.0912. Okay, now let's work on Part C. Part C says the probability a randomly selected individual has an IQ less than 95 is, okay, well now this case, 95 is the biggest the number could be, and it could be any number less than that. So now my upper limit is 95, and my lower limit would be negative infinity, the smallest number I can imagine, or a really big negative number, if that makes sense. So what I want to do is come in here and say second distribution, pick normal CDF. For my lower limit, I want to do negative infinity. So below the 3, you'll see the negative sign. That is the negative sign. It is this button here next to the 6 is the minus operator. You don't want to use that to indicate a negative number. You want to use below the 3, this negative sign. And then I'm going to say negative 10 to the 99th power, and that will simulate negative infinity. Now my upper limit is 95. My mean is 100, and my standard deviation is 15. So I go and I paste this into the command screen and hit enter, and I get my result. The probability a randomly selected individual has an IQ less than 95 is 0.3694. And that is how you find probabilities using the normal CDF function.